Thank you to Omaze for sponsoring today's episode. To support a great cause and potentially win a Tesla Model S Plaid, go to omaze.com/scishow. The news is all about birds this week. Well, our news at least, and really, what else do you need to know? So first up, a review paper out this week in Trends in Ecology and Evolution suggests that certain bird species, as well as other animals, may be sort of shape-shifting to keep up with the climate crisis. In particular, scientists were looking at a general pattern naturalists have noticed called Allen's Rule. Picture a bird, like a little sparrow or something, sitting on a branch in a snowy forest, trying to keep warm. Most of its body is covered in feathers, which it can poof up for insulation. But not its beak, which is naked. This makes the beak kind of a weak point, a little uninsulated spot where the poofy sparrow will lose body heat, putting it at risk of bird hypothermia. So you might imagine that in this snowy forest, having a tiny beak might be advantageous because you're minimizing heat loss. On the other hand, take that little bird and put it in a desert where the bird is no longer at risk of hypothermia, but instead birdie heat stroke. There, maybe a big honkin' schnoz would be better, since it can help heat escape. And that's the logic behind Allen's Rule. In short, warm-blooded animals tend to evolve to have bigger, heat-radiating appendages, like ears, tails, or beaks, in warmer areas, and smaller ones in colder areas. And indeed, we do generally see this play out in lots of species, including birds. But what's interesting here today is that all around the world, the average temperature of different regions is rising due to the climate crisis, which begs the question of whether we'll see a corresponding shift in the size of heat-radiating appendages as predicted by Allen's Rule, like if the average size of certain birds' beaks has increased over time in areas that are getting warmer. To figure this out, the researchers in this study compiled and sifted through studies of both old museum collections and living animals in the wild. And lo and behold, it seems like this is indeed happening to many animal populations around the world. For example, it turns out that Australian parrots are getting bigger bills, with changes lining up with the average summer high temperatures in the 5 years before collection. And in the North American dark-eyed junco, which is an extremely cute little bird, bigger bill sizes were associated with episodes of unusually warm winter weather. And the researchers saw this in mammals too, such as increasingly large appendages in shrews and bats. Now, it's worth pointing out that this doesn't mean that individual animals are morphing their bodies. Rather, it reflects an overall shift in the population over time thanks to natural selection. So it's the average appendage. And it's difficult to actually tie any one particular change to the climate crisis specifically, since there are a lot of other factors, like possible changes in food sources, that could be responsible. Nevertheless, taken as a whole, there is enough there to argue that this is happening on a broad scale. Now, speaking of birds with big schnozzes, let's zoom in on the Southern Hemisphere for our second story. Aotearoa, New Zealand, if you didn't know, is home to the kakapo, a large flightless parrot that's just, well, just look at it. I think we can all just really enjoy the fact that this bird exists. Unfortunately, like a lot of large flightless birds that live on islands, while it used to be really common before people, today it's pretty rare. While their historic numbers may have been in the hundreds of thousands, by 1995 they dropped to 51 individuals. 50 on an isolated island, and just one named Richard Henry on the mainland. Today, their numbers have improved, up to about 200. But going through such a sudden population drop is rarely good news for a species. Even if kakapos were to swell back up to previous numbers, they still seem to have lost about 70 to 80% of their previous genetic diversity. This kind of population bottleneck generally results in inbreeding, which typically increases the number of harmful mutations present in a population's collective DNA. But remarkably, these parrots may actually be doing better than we'd expect. Scientists publishing this week in Cell Genomics analyzed the genomes of 36 modern individuals and compared them to DNA from 13 130-year-old specimens from the mainland, that is, before the bottleneck took place and the mainland population went extinct. They found that the current population actually seems to have lower overall numbers of potentially harmful mutations, counter to what we'd expect. Now, this could be partly due to genetic drift, which is basically just the random chance of a mutation disappearing. But it could also be the result of something called purging. See, in a large population, harmful variants of genes are more likely to get spread around and paired with healthier versions, so they don't end up having much impact. But in a small population, as happens with inbreeding, the mutations are more likely to get concentrated in individuals, and then natural selection kind of does its thing. Basically, in smaller populations, the harmful mutations have a harder time hiding. Unfortunately, kakapos still experience other problems as a result of their small population. For example, their eggs have a relatively low chance of hatching, which may be a result of inbreeding. But the good news is that these findings could be helpful in protecting and growing the kakapo population. So they're still critically endangered, but it does give us a bit more hope about keeping these birds around for a long time. Thank you to Omaze for sponsoring this episode. Omaze is a fundraising platform that gives everyone a chance to win unique prizes while helping to make the world a better place. Right now, they're partnering with Reverb.org to offer a chance to win a Tesla Model S Plaid. Reverb works with musicians, festivals, and venues to make events greener by eliminating single-use plastic water bottles at concerts, composting and donating food waste, and using sustainable biodiesel in tour buses. They hope to inspire both music lovers and creators to take environmental and social action that collectively creates large-scale, measurable change. If you'd like to support Reverb and potentially win a Tesla Model S Plaid, you can go to omaze.com/scishow to get started.